at Outlaw Edge. Sorry about the wind noise. So we just did another estate clean out sale, and we went and got everything, and we got to get another couple loads we got to go pick up. But I figured I'd show you just some of the stuff that was sitting in the scrap metal piles that we grabbed. And I have boxes and boxes of this kind of stuff. Raw aluminum, billet aluminum, chunks. And there's just tons of this, like boxes of this kind of stuff. Lots of raccoon crap, all aluminum. I picked up a lot of stainless, and then tons and tons of chunks of brass, copper, boat propellers, old vintage pulleys, vintage traps, old Champion spark plug cleaners, freaking stuff for horses, tons and tons of tools. There was stuff like this, boxes of this stuff just laying in the scrap metal pile, and I grabbed it just so we could throw it in our showroom or sell it or swap meet it or whatever. We got this stuff for almost nothing, and I got just massive amounts of stuff. And this is just the back of the truck. I got the truck that I still have to empty out, the trailers that I got to empty out. We got trailer loads today that we have to still go pick up. But as I'm pulling some of the stuff out, I'll kind of show you guys some of the score we got. So as I'm unloading this stuff, there's we got lots of vintage wagons. We picked up like six of these, I believe. And then there's just tons of old car parts, lots of spotlights, and they're intact, the Lucite handles. And then lots of stuff like this. These are the old vintage aftermarket tissue holders for the dashboards of the cars. Hoods, fenders, doors, jack stands, carburetors, gauge sets, just tons of crap. And then in this box, these are brand new surface or grinder wheels. There's unopened saws and hacksaws down below. Boxes and boxes of unopened flapper sander wheels and sanding wheels, and then grinding discs and wire brush deals for your grinder. Oh my gosh, tons of stuff. So there's no way I'm gonna be able to show you guys everything that we got in the next couple days, but if I get time when I'm putting the stuff away, I'll kind of do a couple quick videos. And this is an old spare tire cover. Put the spare tire in there, and then it mounts on the back of the car. We got tons of these, just boxes and boxes of these insulators with the wooden rods that go with them. A lot of vintage NOS mirrors, lights, car parts, license plates, and hubcaps and wheels. Tons of these pulleys like this, these giant pulleys. And we got boxes and boxes of these things, like truckloads of them, in all different shapes and sizes. Car stereos, a lot of wooden stuff like this that's all, you know, has the manufacturer name on them and stuff. Parts for 49 through 54 Chevy trucks, square body Chevys, stereos, lights, hubcaps, old vintage Champion spark plug cleaners, metal boxes, wooden boxes, tool boxes. Love this though. These freaking valve covers are to die for. Small box Chevy Corvette. Love that. You know, 283, 327 valve covers and gauges, and NOS taillights, never been used. Just boxes of traps and pulleys and freaking everything. And I will go in the shop and show you the other stuff. So like I said, as I'm doing this stuff and I'm pulling stuff out of boxes and whatever, I'll kind of show you some of the stuff we got. This guy had a lot of stuff in bulk, I guess for the weight, because it was a junkyard. And we got boxes and boxes of these ball bearings, aluminum cutoffs, brass, copper, a lot of different metal shapes, which I love. And then there's brass inside of them. Just tons of crap, you know. Aluminum, tons and tons of these. I mean, I have boxes of this stuff right here. And then the guy had like a rivet fetish or something. These are all boxes of rivets, and I forgot what was in this one. You know, there's a lot of brand new hardware that we got, and old oil cans, just cool stuff like this. Tons of this stuff. And this is a brand new bags of screws, rivets. More rivets, I think. Yeah, these are rivets. These are all brand new, and they're not they're not all crappy or nothing either. They're brand new right out of the box, you know? And then I have boxes and boxes of hardware like this, brand new nylons and nylock nuts and stuff, you know, 1/4 inch, 3/8, 5/16, whatever. Old metal shaping files, or metal file, whatever the hell you call them. This is kick-ass right here, big old crescent wrench. Look at the size of this thing. Super cool. And we have boxes of stuff like this, old vintage lights, tail lights, headlights, old cutters, pry bar hammers, which this is going in my collection. And then I thought this was badass. I threw it in one of the boxes. It was in the junk pile. And it was, this is an old cable cutter. And then also you put the battery cables on, like big rigs and stuff. Fell in love with this. This is going in my personal collection. I'm not gonna get rid of this. Thought that was really sweet. That's an old license plate aftermarket deal for an insurance company that goes on your back of your plates. Stuff like this, big old pieces of brass. And I got some bronze and copper and steel and a whole bunch of different stuff, piles and piles of this stuff like this. And, you know, more stuff like the taps and dies that are ginormous, badass little oil cans, whole bunch of just cut off boxes of these. There's just all kinds of shapes and sizes of stuff like this. Putty knives and pocket, you know, knives. And then there's the old ladle, or what do they call this? A crucible or some crap? I forget what the hell it's called. What do you guys know what it's called? Leave a comment down below if you guys know what this is called. A ladle, right? But it's for pouring like lead weights or aluminum or whatever. And then these Yankee screwdrivers, if 357 Magdad and Resto Rob are watching, you guys will love these. Look at all these Yankee screwdrivers right here. And this old drill. Another Yankee right here. And then this, I found this in the aluminum pile. It's brand new. I'll use that all over the place because it's just cool. There was tons of stuff like this in boxes. There ain't nothing wrong with that. I'll clean it up, use it. And then, of course, I found boxes and boxes of hammers. I don't even have them all in front of me right now. I just wanted to show you some of the cool ones that were there. Love this one, machinist hammer. That is sweet right there. And then there's boxes of this stuff in the back of the trailers that some of the boxes are so heavy I can't even pick up. This is solid aluminum, you know, so we can put that on the mill and mill something out. And then there's boxes and cans full of these old clamps. And these we'll use on the drill press. You know, you got the small side and then the big side for pipe, drilling holes through pipe and whatever. Old hammers. Got me another oxygen and acetylene lid so I can do another hammer. And then, damn it. And then there was some lead hammers. There's a bunch of these in there. And other style machinist hammers. Maybe you guys know what the hell this thing is. Look at this freaking ball peen hammer. I've never seen one of these. I'm sure Ben from Tool Attic will know what it is, or 357 Magdad or Scout Crafter, one of those guys will know. And I know right now, Ralphie's Customs, he's drooling over this. These hammers are just sweet. And there's just boxes of this stuff, the old vintage tools, old Ford Model A tools and stuff, or Model T tools, whatever they are. Lots of hammer handles. And I've never seen one of these. I've always seen like this, damn it. I've always seen like this style claw hammer with a head here and then a claw on this side. But this literally is the first one in my life I've ever seen that has the head on both sides. I just thought that was really cool. So I'm keeping this one. This is going to my personal collection also. Tack hammer. Ball peens. Nice little machinist, blacksmith style hammer. And some big files. I'll clean these up. They're nice and sharp. I'll use those. I'll use you know, the file card and clean them up. And then some axes, hatchets, whatever. But check this out. This is badass right here. These locks are solid brass. Freaking solid ass brass. So yes, these we will be going in our showroom. And they'll be for sale. And we will put them on eBay and whatever on our store. Anyways, I do not have a lot of time today. I gotta go get some more loads of this stuff, and I will be bringing truckloads of this stuff back to the shop. We bought the whole estate sale. So like I said, as I'm coming back, if I get time when I'm unloading stuff that I wanna keep, I'll put stuff on the table and show you guys. If not, I'll just lay it out on the ground and show you as I'm cleaning stuff and putting it away. But holy crap, what a score. Anyways, thanks for watching, guys. Later. All right, on the back of the truck, I was going to show you this too. Look at this whole heater. Maybe I'll put that in a Roadster or something, or in the 35 or whatever. This is badass right there. I like that. I like how it looks like an old vintage car grill, you know? It's got a little medallion, or a spot for medallion or something in the center. And then Heidi grabbed these, I guess, because I didn't even see these. Freaking ginormous pulleys. We got one of them that's like the size of a garbage can lid. And then a whole bunch of pulleys. And then check these babies out. We got sets of these. Yeah. You guys know what those are. Those are sick. It's tons of stuff. Oh, and I gotta change my valve in my Briggs & Stratton motor. Thought you guys would like to see that. Later.